Welcome back to Pop Dust Presents. I'm your host, Brent Butler. And today, very special, a unique interview and performance. We've got fashion designer Milan and Consuelo Vanderbilt Kosten.
Yes.
First of all, where are you guys right now?
Both in New York, but we're actually very close to Times Square.
Oh, that's where our headquarters is normally when we're not in a pandemic.
And we're in a great studio here, and thank you so much for debuting our single.
Thank you so much for that. So fun,
and thank you. It's really an honor to be with you tonight.
I think it's super interesting. Like, how did this come about? Because, you know, Milan, I think you're mostly known as a fashion designer. There's obviously a lot of intersection between fashion and music, surely. And I know you guys worked with the producer Alex Davies on this, and it's a Christmas tune. How did this all come about?
I was in London. We had the idea of coming. We've had the idea of coming together for some time. Last summer I was in New York for the opening of Moulin Rouge on Broadway, and we were out afterwards. Well, not actually afterwards. The day after, yeah. At a piano bar in New York, and we sang together at the piano bar. And then it was just kind of like, maybe we should do something together. And that thought was kind of in our heads for a while. And then with Christmas coming up and everything, it just sort of worked out that we recorded the single.
We collaborated on a lot of other projects in the past. So between technology, yeah. Between modeling and new shows, like we've had such a creative friendship that it was just so much fun to be able to do this with him. And to really give back as well, you know? I think that the song is really important for him.
Yeah, that's awesome. How did you choose the record for Christmas? What made you land on this one in particular?
We both have, especially Milan being in London, I'm being in New York, and watching just over the last, 8 to 9 months, just so much sadness and despair and people, what does home really represent? Home really represents, who your family is, who your friends are. And so this just seemed absolutely the right fit for a message. And even the video, right?
Yeah, about the video
coming back to together.
Coming together in a time. It's been such a very devastating time for so many of the people in the world. And I know a lot of people want to be with their families this year. And so I thought the two of us on this song would be so lovely, coming together. Maybe giving some people some hope.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, no, I think that's beautiful, and it's definitely the right time for it. Oh, and you guys have the video coming out for this, right?
We do, yeah.
Yeah, I think it goes live tomorrow, actually, so.
Very exciting. And that was filmed.
World Museum and Planetarium, which is my great-great-grandfather's home. And
Wow. What's
so remarkable about being able to share with Milan this, this amazing property that, I feel so proud. My great-great-grandfather was an incredible voyager. And so he collected all these insane artifacts from like a mummy to weird mollusks. Like, it's just, right?
Yeah,
it's so unbelievable. And so it was so much fun to be there, and they loved it, and it was so Christmassy and delicious. And anyone that hasn't been there, please go, because it's really a very special place.
That sounds amazing. Sounds like the coolest place to film a music video. There's like old artifacts from around the world and stuff.
Right.
There's a ton of like props already built in. Sounds very, very cool. So looking forward to that. Yeah, excited to see the video for that. So you guys have been collaborating before, and Milan, you've done music before. I know you have a take on the song Something Stupid.
We did Something Stupid right before lockdown, and that was my first single out. And but before that, I worked in theater and performed pretty much all over the world, like in London, Japan, Taiwan, all over. So it's been, I've been in music since I was about 3.5 years old. And as a pianist and as a violinist and a flautist. And a, is it flautist?
It's yeah, a flautist, yeah.
And I also play the tuba as well, so.
Wow.
He doesn't do a lot of things.
No,
it's
very
hard. It's very hard. It's so sad. If you could just be a little bit more creative, it's really, it's.
I learned to play the guitar in lockdown as well. Well, I learned before that, but I kind of perfected it in lockdown. So,
I should be playing more. I've got one in the background. I personally found it difficult, even though we're all home way more, to have the same motivation, just because like there haven't been shows and everything. So I think that it's great that you guys are putting out music and performing live, you know, through Zoom on Facebook. And yeah, I think that's some good energy to put out into the world.
We do. That's how we feel. That's what's been really important about doing this together.
Yeah. Consuelo, you have some entrepreneurial ventures of your own outside of music. It's pretty interesting. Both of you guys are Renaissance people, it would seem, doing everything from design and fashion and music and apparently playing every instrument ever, to launching some, you know, tech startups, including Soho Muse, which sounds really interesting, a place for creatives to find, you know, other creatives and jobs. If you want to talk a bit about that.
Being a singer my whole life and being on tour and, you know, having the issue that basically you could lose talent immediately. Like, you know, for instance, like I was on tour in Germany and I lost a dancer in 24 hours and management had to go and find a dancer. And it's one of those things, like how to find immediate talent in a very vetted community. So Soho Muse works with all 11 verticals, whether you're an actor, a dancer, a writer, a musician, and helping to build projects. So if you're putting together a music video or a fashion show or, you know, a film project, and so we do, we vet the talent and we help to provide, you know, incredible collaboration, and then we also help in the distribution. So it's really kind of a all-encompassing 360 amazing network and community of extraordinary creatives.
And all of the people that worked on the music video are members of the Soho Muse as well.
That's amazing. Yeah, and I think now more than ever, having creative ways through technology to stay connected and collaborate on projects is super important, especially when it's, you know, definitely a challenging time for folks that are normally performers and whatnot to get work in the same way and share their skills. So, yeah, that's definitely an invaluable resource to have.
We put together a save series because a lot of our artists who are normally on tour, just as you said, or session musicians or Broadway talent. And so it was such a gift to do sound checks with them the day before, making sure that everyone's taken care of. And every single one of our members generated an income through this. And just at least it provided an additional platform for them to really being able to showcase their work and their talents. Because you're right, we don't know when this is going to come back. So that was really a gift to do that.
Brilliant. Well, can you tell us where should people go to see everything? I know if you have the video dropping tomorrow, we'll be adding that to the premiere where we have your SoundCloud right now on popdust.com, and we'll throw some links to that in the comments below. But where else should people find you guys? If there's anything else that you want to share with them?
If you want to, you can stream the song on Spotify, Deezer, Apple Music. It's pretty much all over. So you can stream it there. And myself, if you want to find out more about me, generally, if you want to go to my Instagram, that's probably best, at Milan Breton. And then for Consuelo, she has Soho Muse, which is...
So sohomuse.com/ConsueloCostin, and that's my bio inside of Soho Muse. And then Instagram, Consuelo Vanderbilt Boston. And it would be wonderful to connect with anyone who's with us tonight. So it's really been an honor, and thank you so much for debuting our single.
Yeah, absolutely. And well, thank you guys all for being here, and definitely more to come. Definitely reach out when you have more projects coming out. And yeah, we love it. Love that you're spreading positive energy, connecting creatives all around the world. So keep it up, and thank you guys.
Thank you so much.
Well, yep. From all of us at PopDust, huge thank you to Milan and Consuelo, and we'll be talking to you again soon, I'm very sure.
Thank you.
Thank you.